In this video, I'm going to introduce to you Flexbox, a new and extremely useful feature when creating a responsive project. So, what is it? Flexbox is actually a flexible container that can hold items. A flexbox is made for one-dimensional layouts, which means it can be laid out horizontally or vertically. In a responsive project, you can create your own flexbox or use slides having preset flex layouts. I'm going to introduce it to you in both ways. Let's get started. Here is the first slide of my sleep tips project. As you can see, I used flexbox container layouts, as I wanted the objects to be arranged differently on distinct layouts. To insert a flexbox, in the Home tab, or the Insert tab, click Container. Here you can directly insert a flexbox, or choose preset slide layout and select the layout that you want. I continue to add two more layouts. And this is a complete layout that I got. When working with Flexbox, we mainly use the Properties pane on the right side to customize it. For the title, I'll adjust its height first. By default, the base width and base height are auto. But you can set it to pixel or percent. For example, I set the height to 10%. I continue to change the value of the Grow option. This option is by default equal to 1. And defines the free space of the flexbox to be distributed to its children. You can change the value in the range from 0 to 100. I'll decrease it to 0 so that the flex child would keep its base size. Shrink option is used in case you want objects to shrink to fit the container, if they have a larger total base size than the container size. Change the value of rotation if you want to rotate a flex child. Horizontal or vertical alignment depending on the direction of its flex container. You can use it to align a flex child in different directions. And four margin options here allow you to adjust margin on four sides. Turn back to the title, I continue to add a text caption to this flexbox. I'm going to add content for each of these flexboxes in turn, text and background image, four images, and also an image here. You can fill an image for this text caption by going to the Fill section, clicking Image Fill and choosing an image from your computer. For this flexbox, I'm going to add four images with the same size. And another image for this box. After adding all the objects, I'll specify the ratio for them each, and adjust their position correctly. I would like to make this flexbox to account for 30% of the total container. This column should be about 25% in width. Let's see. Okay, and grow by 0. Since there are 4 images in this column, I'll set the height of each image to 24% to make a little space between them. And I'll lock the aspect ratio to width, adjust their height to 24%. Now that you see there's a small space at the end of the box. That's because the flex container layout's aligned vertically to the top. There are many ways you can select to align here. I'd like the idea of making space around them. So, I'll change it to space around. In the container layout section of Flexbox, you can set the direction to vertical or horizontal, which is so useful when you switch to other layouts in a responsive project. Wrap option specifies objects should be forced into one line or wrapped in multiple lines. The overflow option here determines how the content in a Flex container is displayed, if it overflows the container. I won't use it in my example. But you can take a look at our tutorial linked in the description below for more information. I will decrease this image's size a little. And align it to the middle of its flex layout. Finally, I'll format the text. It looks good now. That's how to create your own flexbox. Let's move to the second part of working with Flexbox by using slides having preset flex layouts. In the Insert tab, click New Slides to choose a slide that you want to add. I'll go with this one. This way is so convenient as all flex layouts are perfectly built and ready to use. You just add the content to it. Then edit as I did in the previous slide. So, I have just shown you how to work with Flexbox, a very new feature in ActivePresenter 8. See you next time.